And this is something that's missing in our community. Economic literacy. Credit is not about money. Credit is about how you pay your bills. So again, we have to teach our children about paying their bills on time and not overextending themselves. Because it's not about, credit is not about money. It's about your ability and the way that you pay your bills. So let's teach our children things that weren't taught to us. There was a time when I was coming up, Rez, when I was in grade school, they started us off with banking debt. You bring in your change or your money and your allowance, and we put it in the bank. We had a passbook savings account. This is when I was in grade school. They took that out of the schools. You know, our children don't understand that money is a tool, that credit is a tool. It's not the end all and be all, but it's a tool. And when it's used properly, it can be a great tool. And when it's not, unfortunately, it can be very detrimental. Because when you have bad credit or low credit scores, these payday vultures, these pawn shops, they prey on our community. So you go and pawn something, and they'll hold it for you, and you can buy it back. But you have to buy it back at a lot more than what they gave you for. Or they'll sell it. And you only see pawn shops in our communities. You don't see them in affluent communities. You don't see them in communities that have a lot of banks in them. This is something that's very important. And we as the adults have to pass this on to our children so they don't fall into some of the same traps that we fell into in our earlier generations. They have to understand how to use money and how to use their credit to their advantage. Now, this is all in a bigger scheme of things to help build our own institutions, which would be the bigger focus, you know, to build our own banks, to build our own lending institutions, to build our own credit bureau, credit entities to help people in our community buy homes, cars, and to borrow money for school and things like that. So, you know, I just want people to understand. I'm from New Jersey, where we don't have a lot of payday loans. You're from Carolina. Carolina and Pennsylvania, right? Philadelphia, more specifically. You probably didn't notice because you're a kid, or a younger child, I should call you a kid, a younger child. And you didn't notice that, but there are not a lot of payday loans. There are not a lot of pawn shops in the larger cities. But in rural America, in the South, pawn shops, payday places, they're everywhere. They're everywhere. And we can't continue to fall into the trap of patronizing these places, because they're like vampires. You know, you borrow $500, you have to pay back $800. You know what I'm saying? You already were short, and now you're gonna pay back almost double what you borrowed. You know, that's crazy. 30, 40, and sometimes even 50% interest on these loans. And that is asinine, and it's detrimental to our community. We have to learn to use our tools better. Money is not the end all and be all. Credit is not the end all and be all. But we have to use them for what they are. They're tools in our toolkit of things to help build power. And the only way we can build, you know, part of building and having power is a monetary base. And we can't build a monetary base if we're paying back these exorbitant loans and being raped by these so-called lenders. You know, I mean, the numbers are astounding. McDonald's is the largest fast food industry in the United States. And to have more of something than they have, it's crazy. To have more locations on payday loans than McDonald's and Starbucks combined, it's crazy. It's crazy. And we can't let our children fall into the same trap, people. We have to be aware of this, you know. Like I said to you a few minutes ago, Rez, you know, like you said to me, they're not really going in depth with this. What I will encourage you and others like you, other youth, is talk to your parents about this stuff. Ask questions. Maybe your parents don't know. And going forward, I'm in touch with some people. We're going to set up some literacy clinics for our people. Because when you don't know, you don't know. When you do know, you should teach. So we're gonna here at Real Talk. These are some of the things that we're setting up. We're going to thanks, Kim. We're going to set up clinics to teach about money, so our children can go to school. Because what happens? A lot of us can't afford to send our children to school because of these predatory type loans. You know, outstanding balances, and they go against your credit, and you look crazy. And we have to do better as a people to teach you and our generation to come. Come on, Red, jump on in. You got something?